Welcome to the Scaringe Law Lunch Break. This is your time of the day to learn a little bit about the law while you enjoy your lunch. We've been talking a lot about red flag laws and mental health over the past several days because of these recent mass shootings. We've also talked about how under federal law, someone who is involuntarily committed under Section 302 of the Pennsylvania Mental Health Procedures Act loses his or her right to possess firearms. This is how the federal courts and federal prosecutors have interpreted a particular section of the Federal Gun Control Act, in particular Title 18, Section 922 G4. However, I thought I would take the opportunity to advise you of a significant recent decision by a federal district court of the Eastern District of Pennsylvania. In the case Brandon M. Wilborn v. U.S. Attorney General William Barr, that was decided on August 5th of 2019, just about a week ago. In this case, the court held that an involuntary commitment under Section 302 of the Pennsylvania Mental Health Procedures Act does not satisfy the definition under federal law that bars an individual, quote, who has been adjudicated as a mental defective or who has been committed to a mental institution, end quote, from possessing firearms. In other words, being subject to a 302 mental health commitment does not, under the Pennsylvania Mental Health Procedures Act, does not prohibit one from possessing a firearm under federal law, according to the Federal District Court for the Eastern District of Pennsylvania. I want to just read the particular statute. It's the Title 18 of the United States Code, Section 922 G4. And it states, it shall be unlawful for any person who has been adjudicated as a mental defective or who has been committed to a mental institution from possessing firearms. That's the federal statute. And as I said, to date, federal courts and prosecutors have interpreted that prohibition to apply to individuals committed under the under Section 302 of the Pennsylvania Mental Health Procedures Act. The court in the Eastern District looked at the Code of Federal Regulations and even Black's Law Dictionary for definitions of the words adjudicated and committed. And their conclusion was that something much more is necessary for a commitment under Section 302 to rise to the level of an adjudication or a commitment to a mental institution. Under Section 302 of the PA Mental Health Procedures Act, the person is taken to a hospital and subject to an examination by a physician. And the physician certifies that the person is a clear and present danger to himself or others suffering from a severe mental disorder, and they commit that person involuntarily, meaning against that person's will. That's what happens in a commitment under Section 302. There's no judge. There's no hearing. You don't have an attorney with you. You can't cross-examine the physician. So the Eastern District Court said those are the things you need in order to have an adjudication. So there's no adjudication. So the first clause of the federal statute prohibiting possession doesn't apply in these cases. The second clause, who has been committed to a mental institution, the federal Eastern District Court is saying, no, this is not a commitment. This is simply a temporary stay in a hospital for the purposes of observation. It is something less than a commitment. And so the Eastern District Court is saying neither element of Section 922 G4 of the United States Crimes Code, which is the prohibition section, applies to a person who has been subject to an involuntary commitment under Section 302 of the Mental Health Procedures Act. Now, This is a federal court decision interpreting federal law, a federal statute. It does not affect the Pennsylvania law that also prohibits an individual who has been subject to an involuntary commitment from possessing a firearm. However, this federal case gives an opportunity to individuals who are subject to a 302 in Pennsylvania to have their firearms rights either restored or declared to be intact. Because we can go into state court and challenge the commitment. And now we also have a remedy in federal court to have that commitment declared as one that does not prohibit one from possessing a firearm. I know it's rather complex. Bottom line, if you or a loved one has a prior 302 commitment under the Pennsylvania Mental Health Procedures Act and wishes to have their firearms rights under the Second Amendment either restored or secured, give us a call here at Skowronski Law at 717-657-7770, and we'll explain to you the process involved. Well, that's about all the time we have today for the Skowronski Law Lunch Break. I hope you learned a little bit about the law. Thanks for listening, and enjoy your lunch.